following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do a great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for,
that's awesome,
for a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. It's making a great night, folks. Be impeccable with your word. Manifest your true intentions. Regardless of what language you speak, your intent will be manifested through the word. What you dream, what you feel, and what you really are will be manifested through what you say each and every day. Market wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 63, NASDAQ up 41, S&P's up 10, gold contract up $11.10, trading at 13.0220. We got silver up 19 cents, $15.47 a barrel. Notes and bonds, bottom line, they want higher price. 10-year note up 8 ticks, 122.28. 30-year bond up 26, 146.14. And the 30-year, folks, if we get over here, let's just take a look at the 30-year. The 30-year is going to be, I suspect, a confirmed ABC structure on the way up. We're going to need 270. We're going to get it easy. When I just did the update, that was 269. It's already 272. And we need 277. So your B point on this is 146.06. Your A is 143.5. So we get 2.5. We get approximately 2.5 points, which gives you 147. 148 is game. So it's going to be pretty cool. You got a confirmed ABC structure up now in the 30 that has a price projection of approximately 148, and your high is 147.31. So 32 ticks. Bottom line, we're going to that high. 10-year right now, doing the same thing. It hasn't broken the B point yet. The 10-year right now is yielding 2.6, folks, and a low for the last 12 months is 2.553. If we get over and we take a look at that 10-year, what you're going to see out here, you get 1.4 million contracts. I believe it's 122.30, the B point. And we're at 122, yeah, it is. 122.30 is the number. We're at 122.29, and you'd need 1.8 million contracts. Now, on the 30-year, this will be interesting. I mean, on the 10-year. The 10-year, I actually like to stay right here because that 10-year will not do, I don't think it will do 1.8. Either that or blows that 122.30 out, and then you get a huge amount of contracts that would be coming in at that level. Bottom line, though, it's pushing with volume. It's pushing with volume. It needs more than what it has right now in the 10-year versus the 30-year. 30-year has the deal going. Gold contract and silver contract both have caught a bid. If we go take a look at the silver contract first, what you're looking at is silver is up 1.2% right now. You get gold trading up 0.8%. We take a look at the silver contract, 50,000 contracts out here. Not bad. I'd rather see 70, but it's not bad. It's not an ABC up because it just took out the 70. Took out the high of 15.38. But what you do have now, we're at 15.47. Like to see this get back inside the 15.62. And what that would be, you know, silver had a big down day on March 1st. We went from $15.60 to $15.16, and you had volume on that move. So that's what you'd like to see out there. GDX, the gold equities themselves, they're getting some traction under them. They got 18 million shares. Now, it's going to need more share volume, no doubt. But what you already have, this came off the lows, rejected lower price, got some juice behind it. This is heading for 2370, and we'll see if when we get up at that particular point, do you have enough volume? And that would be on a weekly for an ABC structure on the way up, but you very well could. King Dollar. What do you have with King Dollar? Okay, so King Dollar failed on price, failed on volume once again. DX was still on the H. It's pretty amazing. What happens with the dollar index, they don't roll this thing to the very end. We're still on the March contract. So what we had out here today is that the King Dollar went from 97.245, we're at 96.925, and we did get an expansion of volume as we're going down to lower price here. You did 21,000 contracts. We're inside the lower range. Anything inside basically the 96.995. So we're just getting it. No, we're at 96.920. Now, what you can expect, folks, in the next hour and a half, you are going to get some big action inside the pound as well as the euro. The reason being is that as we are on air live right now, the vote is going on in the UK over basically Brexit. Let's see. This is pretty cool. So this is just starting. And one of the quotes here, you gotta love this. This is, lock the doors, shouts Speaker Burko. If there are any late MPs who aren't in or through the voting lobbies now, they're too late. So this is going to be, I got a live blog here. In fact, here, I'll show this. If you're watching Tiger TV, this is pretty cool. You get a live blog here. And you get, if you're matching up the numbers, we're at 313. And what you're looking at there, right there, that's 310. Live inside the chamber. TV cameras are showing the chamber starting to fill up again. Let's see what they have to say. Okay, below us we can see the Tories who voted against May squeezing their way past the speaker's chair back into the chamber. There seems to be quite a few of them. So as we go through the program, this thing's going to come up for a vote, and we'll see where this shakes out. What we will see, there's no doubt, volatility it will get in the currency markets. And we'll see how this vote is going. And I suspect what's going to probably happen is that, it's quarter past three right now, 13 past three to be exact. We very well could have this cooking before this session is over at 4 o'clock. And if that's the case, you're going to see some big movement, folks. The last time that this happened, if we take a look at the pound, what you had is that the pound, that's when Theresa May, she lost badly on the vote. And what had happened is that the pound dove in an extraordinary manner, and it stayed there for all of a split second. You know, that was on the 15th of January. And so we had got down to 126.70, and we had traded up there to 129 that day, and then it just took right back off topside and actually kept going higher, even with the aspect that she did lose the vote. And I think that had to do with everyone realized that there was not going to be a hard Brexit. Dow's down 90, NASDAQ is up 33, S&P's up 7.5. Coming right back.
Hi, folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-76.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's down 107. NASDAQ is up 28. S&Ps are up 6. And the S&Ps, everything started moving around a bit here right when we get on the air, folks. So this is going to get intriguing. Watching the vote, May just took her seat, so more than likely we're going to see this get underway. The pound is hit is at 130.54 again, slipping against the euro. I'll let you know when this baby starts. If we take a look at the S&P, the high today is 28.03. Right now you're at 27.95, and let's see, yeah, 27.92 is the number to keep your eye on. You know, because you have no juice to the top side out here today, and we'll see whether they give it up on price. You got another monster scandal out here. This one has to do with the amount of money. When you hear the amount of money, folks, that people, how this whole scheme went, it's pretty amazing, actually. Parents, coaches charged in a vast college admission plot. This is like sick. So parents, university coaches, and college administrative counselors were among dozens charged Tuesday in a criminal conspiracy that sought to help applicants win admission to elite schools, including Yale, Stanford, UCLA, and Georgetown. Wealthy parents, including celebrities, top merger attorneys, venture capital CEOs, all alleged to have paid bribes to get their kids into school, giving cash to test takers to help students cheat on the entrance exam, paying coaches to designate applicants as athlete recruits. Look at that. That one's a heavy one. Parents paid from, listen to this, man, this is sick, from $100,000 to $6.5 million in bribes. Whoever could pay $6.5 million to get their child into a school must really be like, have a fortune out of their mind simultaneously. It's like, why didn't they send their kids to good high schools? The parents are a catalog of wealth and privilege. Let's see, investigators detailed a scandal that perverted much of the admission process of the elite college. Unlike most SAT cheating cases, the scheme reached deep into the academy, implicating college officials who allegedly subverted the admissions of universities themselves. Now, this is the number. This is what blows my mind. In all, the government said clients paid $25 million in bribes to coaches and administrators and from 2011 to 2017. So bottom line, you know, they're running about what? That's $6.5 million a year. In some cases, the bribes would be disguised as charitable contributions. An informant involved in the alleged plot said clients could also pay $15,000 to $75,000 to cheat on a standardized test, in some cases getting a proctor to change wrong answers to the test center. And it works. One client asked the informant, according to court papers, every time the informant laughed. The FBI informant said he told parents he alleged cheating and bribery amounted to a side door for wealthy parents at most selective schools. The front door involved children getting in their own merits, and the back door entailed multi-million dollar donations, which was legal as far, but far more expensive. Let's see, what we do is help the wealthiest families in the U.S. get their kids into school, the informant told parents. They want guarantees, and they want to get this thing done. Bottom line is that it's going to be a lot of people in trouble, and I suspect we're going to be surprised about the amount of folks that they could have done it a lot of easier ways than that. Inside the Dow, industrials, Dow's taking a hit right now. Died down $1.25. It's all about Boeing, folks. Boeing out here is putting 171 negative points into the Dow Industrials. If we go take a look at Boeing, what you're going to see is this, you know, let's, okay, so there you go. That was a quick vote. So, UK, sorry about this, folks. UK Parliament rejects May's Brexit deal. UK Parliament rejected May's deal by 391 to 242. May loses the vote on the deal by 149 votes. Quick. So let's back to Boeing for a second. The high volume low of yesterday was 365. Right now you're at 374. You hit 368 today. Another big volume day. This equity, folks, wants a lot lower price. You know, technically it has a problem child in here. Pull this back, and what you're going to see, you're coming off the highs now with volume. You're back in the lower range. Anything back inside 375 is the lower range. That sets up a rundown into the bottom of the range, which is 292. And the volume is a monster. And, of course, they have a public relation problem, you know, because of the fact that they think they would have been better off if the FAA just grounded them all, period. Now what you have is that the rest of the world is grounding all those jets for folks. We're the last ones. Just about the last one standing that haven't. That just tells you a huge amount about the quality of what basically bureaucracies are saying right now, and particularly the FAA. I expect tomorrow, the next day, they're going to have to ground them. You know, the amount of... it just came out, Ray Hood, I believe he was the guy that grounded the Dreamliner. I believe he just came across... I think he was, let me just see something. Yeah, LaHood, Ray LaHood. Okay, so, yeah, he ground the Dreamliner for 123 days. And at that point, yeah, and he just came out and saying flat out that he feels that they should be grounded also. Let's see, it's... former Secretary of Transportation, who grounded the 787 Dreamliner following the fires of the lithium-ion battery packs in 2013. So here's his quote. The flying public has to be assured that these planes are safe and they don't feel that way now, he said by telephone. The Secretary of Transportation should announce today that these planes will be grounded until there is 100% assurance from Boeing that these planes are safe to fly, because unless they can give the assurance that they're not holding up their promise to be a top safety agency in the United States. And there's no doubt about that, man. I mean, you just look around and say, okay, are you kidding? So let's go see. So the vote's done. Bottom line is that, let's go take a look at that euro and take a look at the, so the euro, oops. Well, euro's going higher. So whatever's happened there, euro's going higher, and it's definitely inside the range now. You're up 54 ticks. You're at almost 113. They only get back inside the 112.16 to 112.34. Pound. So look at that. This is pretty wild. That, you know, what you definitely have... is each time these votes come down, it's pretty wild, the aspect of she loses the vote and both of those currencies go higher. Let's see. May says Commons will vote on Wednesday whether to leave without a deal on March 29th. It will be a free vote for the Tories. The no deal vote will be a free vote for the Conservatives while there's no whipping. That reflects the fact that May's party is fundamentally split. Over 70 Tories voted against the vote. Labour whips handled tweets. Yeah, bottom line is that's another big defeat, no doubt. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow's down 92. Nasdaq is up 28. S&P's up 7.5. There's a lot of moving pieces out here, folks, inside of this. So you get that all the MPs are still in the House of Commons. And so here's what May was saying. Let me be clear, May says, voting against leaving without a deal. Let me go. Where are you? Yeah, there is. Okay, let me be clear. May says, voting against leaving without a deal and for an extension won't solve the problems of the country faces. She says, European Union want to know what the UK does want. And Corbyn's calling for a general election. That's probably not going to happen. Here's the wording of the motion of the, that will vote. Okay, here's where the vote's going to come tomorrow. That this House declines to approve leaving the European Union without a withdrawal agreement and a framework on the future relationship on March 29th, 2019, and notes that leaving without a deal remains the default in the UK and the EU law unless this House and the UK ratify an agreement. This House declines to approve leaving the UK without a withdrawal agreement. Okay, so they're going to vote on that tomorrow. And then you have Corbyn is calling for a general election. A referendum sounds more popular on his own benches. And then, we'll see where this is going to shake out. If they're going to have another referendum, or exactly what they're going to come down to. But bottom line is that what we had out here, see, if we go over to the dollar and take a look at the dollar, you're going to see a little bit more weakness inside the dollar because both the pound and the euro are just climbing slightly. Nothing heavy, there's no doubt. There's nothing heavy that's up there. But the index itself, our dollar index, has got weaker. Gold out here, that's hanging tough, up $10. S&Ps look to me like they're going to wander in the desert going down into a flat area as we come into the close. Right now, they're up $6. You're trading at 27.90, but what you do have is that we get plenty of time. You get 35 minutes just for the close, then you get 50 minutes into the first future close, because what you have out here is that the spike that we just got at 20 past, that got some volume down here, so it's not going to take much to get us down into a flat situation. And some of the higher volume equities out here, let's go take a look at them. And this is going to be a low volume market again. Okay, you get GE down 20 cents. Boeing's the big number. That's down $22. You get Advanced Micro up 50 cents. Apple's up $1.60. That's going to be interesting because Apple was up a lot higher than that. Let's go over to Apple. Because Apple absolutely got some juice yesterday. And you took out a B point, had the volume behind the move, and look, it's going to give it up. That's interesting, man. You had the A point. Is that 154? Yeah, it's almost to 21.8 to B, which would get you into the 182. 192. We get to 182. Yeah, this is kind of dying. It's dying as it's running into this supply line. Apple has a huge supply line. That's the real bottom line. It actually does. ICE is, in Apple's case, ICE isn't up until like 210. And right now you're at 150, 180. I don't expect we're going to go near that. But I'm surprised that Apple actually backed down somewhat because it had such a great day yesterday. The XAU, HUI, these indices folks want higher price. You know, we're up $1.34 right now in the XAU. You're trading $176.88. It's going to go after its high. The high is $80. The low of that high is $78. So we're approaching that, baby. I don't get the volumes till later. We look at the Gold Bugs Index. Gold Bugs Index is set up the same way. It's up 356, trading 152. You know, you launched, you're in the higher range. Now, the Gold Bugs Index is leading this thing. And with the Gold Bugs Index leading it, that's important to understand. That is saying that the price of gold has more probability of going higher when the Gold Bugs Index is going higher versus the XAU. And yesterday, 41 million shares inside the Gold Bugs Index. That's big volume. Big volume, no doubt about that. Let's go take a look at the platinum market for a couple of the tigers out here. See if we get a little ABC structure on the way up. Let's see what we got. So platinum's up $18.80. Well, you have, let's see. It's not an ABC up. This is just, maybe we want to know intraday. Is that what you want to know? Let's see. Okay, so it's a monster consolidation. Top's 879. It wants to go after that top. Let me look at this intraday for a second. Yeah, I mean, it has some strength out here. Let me put this on a continuous contract. Okay, so Yeah, this is building cause to get up to the top of the consolidation, which is 879. You're at 835 right now. This is, you know, it's been bouncing along this low for quite some time. Copper, let's go take a look at the copper contract. Copper out here is trading price point of 293. That's up 1%. Good move. Okay, this is good. Copper's going to go after its high. Now, yep, you got an expansion of volume too. Okay, so the last highs in copper at 297 to 75. We get down to 287. You do it. Volume's not that bad. Let's see. 66,000 going against 62. Went right back to where it broke topside from. Now what you have an expansion of volume. This looks to me like you're going to basically take out this 297, which is going to be really positive for the metal market in general, because what has happened is that it seems that the copper market basically is the leader inside this metal market. Copper had taken off first. In fact, let me go look at SCCO, because some of these copper stocks also took off. Yeah, that's, here we go. SCCO, 37. Look at this. Yep. Okay, so check this out. This is going to be cool. This can be an ABC up too. This is the largest copper company in the world, Southern Copper. 37.23. You're going to need, we need like another 75,000 shares coming into the close here. Actually, you need more than that. Yeah, we need more than that. But it's a, it looks like it's 20 minutes. I don't think we're going to get the volume in 20 minutes. But hey, we'll find out. You need about 950 million shares. No, 950,000. And right now you're at 869. Your A point on this, though, would be approximately 30. It's a $7 A to B, which would get you into 42. And when this equity in general, folks, when this equity moves, it loves to move fast, man. I mean, this equity is something else. And when you take a look at these revenues, yeah, $7.7 billion. That's what they do. And they, Mexico, they take out $4 billion. Peru, they take out $2.6 billion. Big numbers, man. No doubt about it. 877-927-6648. We have the Dow Industrials down 111. NASDAQ is up 26. S&P's up 5.5. We'll come right back.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the Tax Opportunity Zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted. Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now. Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien. Welcome back, folks. Dow is down 86. NASDAQ is up 32. S&Ps are up 8.5. Let's go take a look at the financials out here, the XLF. So, yeah, this baby's dying on the vine. Yesterday, decent day, 63 million shares traded. You're still going into 178, but out here today, 26 million, no traction whatsoever. Berkshire Hathaway, BRK, let's go take a look at that. That is the largest weighting structure inside. 47 cents, it's up, same deal. This can't get any traction either. What you get with Berkshire, by the way, folks, is that this is a downtrend. It's been a downtrend for going all the way back to 224. 5 months ago. You get many lower highs and three lower lows. So we'll see where this whole thing ends up shaking out. If I take this and put this on a longer term chart just for a second. Yeah, look at that. We've been in a consolidation since December of 2017. It's trading the same price it was December 2017. So that is a long period. There's no two ways about that. Energy market out here, the XLE, and we will get, I'll get the API numbers at 4:30 this afternoon. XLE right now at 36 cents, same setup. You know, this consolidation's been out here quite some time, but you don't have buyers out here, folks. That's what's going on. Yesterday, what you had is this. You had nice price spread yesterday. There's no doubt about that. You had the price spread. You didn't have the volume behind the move, and the indices themselves are not even close to basically denting the October 10th downdraft. They're going to have to get a lot more juice in order to do that because you've come into those downdraft levels and just nothing is there. If we go back and we check on the Newmont Barrick deal, you get Newmont trading up $1.09 out here today, trading $34.54. Now that's going to help Goldcorp because you remember it's 0.3280. Yeah, there you go. Gold Corp is also up 34 cents, trading 11.26. So Gold Corp now, folks, will trade off of Newmont. And it's 0.3280 of a Newmont share. Let me just do this number right now and see how close we are. So you get 34, let's see where we're at. Okay, 34.53, right? 34.53 times 0.3280 is 11.32. And if we go over to Gold Corp, you're at 11.26. There you go. So that's saying that this deal is going to get done, too. You're playing within 6 pennies of the deal. That's how this is shaking out. So now if you happen to be looking at this, you're going to be just watching Newmont more than anything because that is how this thing's going to shake out. I believe the next meeting to get this thing done is the second week of April. That's how this thing is just shaking out. You get some shareholders, no doubt, that totally flipped out about how much Ian Telfer is getting, who's the chairman of Goldcorp. Telfer's lump sum retirement allowance will be about $12 million. If they merge versus the current entitlement of $4.5 million, not a bad paycheck. And so that one of the large funds that own it is saying that this is an outrageous package offered to Goldcorp CEO, Osler CEO. While Goldcorp is telling its shareholders to sell their shares close to a 13-year low, Goldcorp management stands to reap over $33 million in potential change of control payments. Oh, man, I'm telling you. Pretty intense. That's change of control. That's why, you know, you do see folks on a basis quite a bit. When there's changes of control, it's getting the folks in the executive positions that can make those decisions. It's basically legally bribing them. That's how a lot of these things come down. There's no doubt about it, man. It's pretty intense when you look at it. One second you get 4.1 for retirement, except if you get change of control, now you're at 12. $8 million gets sucked out of it in about a second. There's no doubt about that. Let's go inside the NDX 100, because what we have had is that the last 2 days, NDX has been the strongest index out here. You're up $43 right now. You got Align Technology up 3%. Sirius Satellite's up 3%. You got AMD up 2.3%, and JD.com is up 2.1%. Now, taken away from it, it's the airlines. United is down 2.8%. You get American down 2.7%. Tesla is off 2.7%, and you get Monster Beverage down 1.6%. Let's go over to United for a second. Take a look at United. United's down 240 at the lower end of its consolidation. Let's go look at Southwest. Southwest down $1.20. Now, these are all in big consolidations, and it looks to me like they want to go to the bottom of the consolidation. Now, American Airlines is the weakest out here. Has been for a long period of time. American. Where are you, American Airlines? Oh, AAL, I think. Okay, yeah, AAL. So the low for the year is 28, the high is 57. You're trading 31.14. Yeah, this is going to the lower end of. So you're down off $59, which is the beginning of January 2018, that is. Yeah, you're going after this $24 level. This is going to be a total round trip for American. And this is after, I'm not sure how many bankruptcies, folks. Because when you pull American back, it's like American's only been in business for, you know, basically 4 or 5 years. And we know that American's been around forever. But the chart that you're looking at is the new chart after the BK. And they've done that quite a few times. And, you know, we'll see whether that's lining up for it again. Coming into the closeout here, the GDX, we're getting more juice inside this GDX. Right now, you're up 43 cents. You're at $22.72. Yep, this is going to close with its highs, and they're going to, we just might even have a small ABC structure up as we're coming into that close. And what that's going to be all about is that what you're going to see out here tonight, there's still going to be a lot of movement inside the euro. There's going to be a lot of movement inside the pound. It seems that the way that the Brexit Live is still going over there, that you have one side saying to them, listen, we're not going to go a hard Brexit out of here. Their Chamber of Commerce are going basically out of their mind, saying, okay, enough of this politics. Okay, we can't have a hard Brexit coming out. It seemed like a hard Brexit was like out of the question. I think it still is. I think what we're going to have out here tomorrow is that you're going to have the vote on doing a hard Brexit again. But then what you're going to have, it's going to be the extension. I suspect the extension is going to be the deal. And they've all just left the chamber. Dow Industrials down 84, Nasdaq up 36, S&P's up 8.5. Come right back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated fulvic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. Dow down 82, NASDAQ up 34, S&P's up 7.5. Let's go take a look at that British pound. So, you have the pound out here, folks, trading 130.66. You've had quite a move out here today. You know, we got all the way up to 132.89. You got down to 130.005. And you're basically not at the lows, not at the highs of the day. You know, what you're going to have out here, this is going to be a rerun of votes out here tomorrow, because what you're going to be voting on tomorrow, this is going to get interesting. You're going to have a vote of extending the Article 50, or go once again that, listen, we're just leaving. And a couple of the premiers are saying, well, what happens if we they vote them both down? It's like going to be pretty wild watching this thing shake out, you know. And we'll see whether the extension, the extension looks to me like it's going to be in play, you know, and we'll see how long the extension is going to be and what that's going to mean specifically. And we know one thing with politicians, they extend it for a year and a half, then we'll be out there, and 3 days before the year and a half is up, that's when we'll be dealing with whether they're going to stay or leave again. You know, that's how this seems to be shaking out. As we're coming into the close out here, you get basically a flat market. What they have done, it's kind of interesting. You know, the composite was the strongest indice up here, but they're basically selling that composite away right now. Let me go take a look at the NDX 100, and that's a bad sign in particular. NDX Qs are up 80 cents, and I believe that right when I started this show, the number that we're looking at is 179.75. Yeah, so what's going to happen here, it looks like it's going to be a failure in price, failure in volume, as it went into the highs of the last high, which is March 4th. March 4th, 175.79, 38 million. You get 31 million. Doesn't look like we're going to close at that level. We'll give it some time. Bottom line, 4 minutes is a lot of time inside the NDX 100. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This is TFNN, the Tiger Financial News Network. TFNN, headline news update. Here's Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. We had the Dow Industrials finish down 87. NASDAQ was up 32. S&P's up 7.5. And if we go over, first we'll take a look at the SPY, folks. What you have with the SPY is that it traded up a buck. You have 68 million shares traded. Yesterday it did 65. Bottom line is still going into 214 million. Big numbers. NDX 100, 3 Qs. You get a failure in price, failure in volume as you got into the highs of the 4th of March. We hit a high today of 176.14. You closed at 175.69, which was below the high that we're trading into. You did 32 million shares versus 38. So bottom line, subtle, but you got a failure there, price and volume. Small caps. Now, the small caps have been the weakest. Bottom line, still the weakest out here. Small caps are up 8 cents today. The high in the small caps, 159.50 inside the IWM here at 154. And 154.37, bottom line, no action there. Gold contract. Gold contract caught a bid, as did silver. The gold contract today, you're up $10.90. You're trading at 13.02. You've done 193,000 contracts. Nice contract volume. You're going into big contract volume. However, we're going into the downdraft that was created out here on the 1st. That's when gold went down 13.16 to 12.91. That being said, you're eating right into that line. And silver also came up with really good bids out here today. Silver was up 1.1%. You did volume of 51,000 contracts, nice contract volume. Notes and bonds are still saying that all that they want, higher price, lower yield. What has also happened, folks, is this, is that as these want higher price, lower yield, what you're dealing with is that that is what's also pushing that metals market. Because guess what? When we're talking about interest rates that continue to go down, right now the 10-year is just, it's at 2.600. So we are going to be under 2.6 tomorrow. What we have out here in the 10-year is that you come into the swing point today, you have the volume come into the swing point. This is going to go after the highs of January 3rd, and I expect we're going to see that tomorrow. And it looks like the 30-year wants to actually take it out, which is pretty amazing. Stay right there, folks. We're going to be coming back with numbers after the close. Recap, we have the Dow Industrials down 96, NASDAQ up 32, S&P's up 6.5. Come right back.
TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technician's Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you're in the CD market and looking for a secure investment, the Tiger First Mortgage Program may work for you. The security for these first mortgages are building lots in the tax opportunity zone in St. Petersburg, Florida. The Tax Act of 2018 set up tax-free zones across the country where you can build and hold for 10 years and pay no tax on the profits, which makes these lots valuable. The investment is anywhere from $30,000 to $75,000. The interest paid is 7% yearly, paid on a monthly basis. According to Bankrate.com, the best rate for a four-year CD in the country as of February 20th is 3.1%. A $50,000 investment at a normal four-year CD rate of 3.1% would give you income of $1,550 per year or $6,200 over the four-year period. That same $50,000 investment in the Tiger First Mortgage Program would give you $3,500 per year or $14,000 over the 4 years. Which would you prefer, $6,200 or $14,000 of interest on your investment? If you would like more information about the Tiger First Mortgage Program, you can call me at 877-518-9190. That's 877-518-9190.
The Path of Least Resistance is David White's daily trading newsletter, and if you're looking for active trading ideas, then now's a perfect time for a 30-day free trial to this powerful daily trading advisory service. David uses his years of trading experience to offer his subscribers his trading ideas each morning in his Path of Least Resistance newsletter. Using a combination of equity trades along with options, David keeps his subscribers up to date with all pertinent market information with intraday afternoon updates when warranted.
Don't miss out on this great chance to get a 30-day free trial to David's daily newsletter, The Path of Least Resistance, with no obligation to pay anything. David has been delivering solid recommendations for his subscribers recently, and if you'd like to see the type of newsletter he delivers every morning, then visit the front page of TFNN, and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters. For all the details and to start your 30-day free trial today, log on to TFNN.com now.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look, oh, it's a beautiful thing. Got our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We're going to take him by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But yeah. Holy I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. To master love, you have to practice love. The art of relationship is whole mastery, and the only way to reach mastery is with practice. To master a relationship is therefore about action, not about attaining knowledge. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials finish down 96. NASDAQ was up 32. S&P's up 7.5. Gold contract up $11, trading at 13.02.10. We had silver up 17 cents, $15.45 an ounce. Light sweet crude up 13 cents, $56.92 a barrel. We'll have the API numbers out coming out at 4:30. See what kind of inventories we have. Excuse me, folks. Sorry about that. Notes and bonds, higher price, lower yield. Pretty amazing. I mean, this note and bond market, man, 6 months ago, bottom line, if you tell any of us that we're going to be at, there it goes. I love it. It just hit a 2.5, folks, 2.598. And the low for the year is last 12 months is 2.553. Note and bond market not only want higher price, they both, and we're going to go through this, they both look to be ABC structures on the way up. And that would take them into and more than likely over their January highs. King dollar down 297 ticks, trading 96.895. The euro is trading at a price point of 112.97 to one U.S. dollar. The yen is at 111.25, and the pound is at 130.64. You're going to see some movement all night long, folks, inside of the pound and the yen. You had Theresa May, bottom line, another failure on the votes up there. I think they were expecting it. Theresa May, she only got three more votes than she did last time. Parliament voted 391 to 242, rejecting the revised divorce agreement. They're going to be back at it tomorrow. They're going to be back at it. Two separate votes tomorrow. One is going to be, do they do a hard Brexit vote again? Out. The other one's going to be an extension. May's coming across saying if it's an extension, it's got to be a short extension. Hey, we'll see where that whole thing shakes out. Notes and bonds. We take a look at the 10-year note. What do you have out here with the 10-year note? Bottom line. It did 1.6 million contracts out here. You're at 122.29, and I believe it needed just 1.8 million contracts. You're at an ABC structure up. I expect more than likely we'll get it tomorrow. The B point is 122.30. We hit 122.31. The high out here is 123.17. We're not up 9 ticks today. My take is that. So what you have here inside the note and bond is this. We have consolidated at this price point since the beginning of 2019. That's not the large part. The large part, folks, is that the note and bond market has not backed down at all for basically over 2 months. We did a 0.382 retracement from the lows that was established out here in October and November. That is a strong market. It's a particularly really strong market. Let's go take a look at the TLT, which is the ETF. And that's doing it too. Is that going to be an ABC up? No. They need another million shares. But yeah, the TLT go up 85 cents today. Takes out swing point that had 7.5 million. We did 6.3. This thing is also going for this highs. It's going for the 123.86 mark. And, you know, will these rates have gone down dramatically. If we take a look at the last 12 months, what you're going to see is that the low is 2.553. The high is 3.287. We're at 2.594. So pretty amazing. And there's no reason that we can't bust that through, folks. That's the way this thing is looking at this particular point. King dollar. What do you have with king dollar? King dollar, folks. Bottom line, let's go. We're still on the H contract, hard to believe, because March 19th is next week. But guess what? King dollar came downtown, did have an expansion of volume. We're down 279 ticks, had 25,000 contracts traded. We closed at 96,895. Now, you need to close below 96,765, you know, to really get some traction going. The reason I'm saying that is this, folks. Last week, when we went topside, that was the beginning of the move, 96,765. You had volume out there of 27,000 contracts, which was good volume, by the way. So you broke topside. You failed on price, failed on volume once again. You had an expansion of volume today. We'll see whether we get that tomorrow. What the market is saying, when I say the market, the currency markets, the euro, the dollar index, and the pound, is that they're saying that it's either going to be extension, they're going to figure something out. There's not going to be a hard Brexit, because a hard Brexit, I mean, it came up again today, you know, once this vote was taken care of, that, you know, their Chamber of Commerce was coming out saying, are you, you know, like out of your mind that you're going to even think about having a hard Brexit? You know, most of the politicians out there are saying that, including the Attorney General, is saying a postponement is inevitable, meaning an extension of the move. Because we're talking about, the move that they're talking about is on March 29th, and we're at March 12th, I believe, right? Pretty amazing. XAU, HUI, inside the gold, folks, higher price. Good moves out here. XAU today was up $1.54, trading 77.07. Gold Bugs Index even stronger. And what that's saying is that that's saying that what you're going to see is that the metal price also will continue higher. Up to $3.98 today in the Gold Bugs Index, trading 173.17. Your last high out here is 180, with the low of that high being 175. So I expect we're going to see out here more than likely tomorrow, you're going to see us trying to get into that level. As the dollar starts pulling back, bonds still want higher price, and I suspect the metals are going to want higher price and make a run for those higher priced. We go take a look at the volume inside the NYSE, light volume, 865 on the NYSE. We take a look at the NASDAQ composite, you're at 2.1. So bottom line, you get light volume all around. Dow finished down 96, NASDAQ up 32, S&P's up 8. Come right back.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter.
If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find market insights under trading newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Welcome back, folks. Dow finished down 96, NASDAQ up 32, S&P's up 8.5, eight points rather. So check this out. This morning, Tommy and I were talking about the, maybe it was yesterday morning, the ETF structures that you have. J.P. Morgan's coming out, folks, with a ETF without any fees whatsoever. And we're talking about, okay, you're going to go into the negative? Well, guess what? This just came across the tape. Yes, we are going to go into the negative. So check out how this works now. So Salt Financial plans to give away 50 cents for every $1,000 invested. Now, this is how this will work. Free is no longer cheap enough in the ultra-competitive market for exchange-traded funds. Salt Financial, which has one small ETF. They're not a big part of the ETF business, but I'll show you what they're going to do here. They only have one small ETF right now that has $10 million into it, so evidently no one is trading that ETF. What they plan, in order to woo buyers to the fund, that they're temporarily going to pay them to invest, according to the regulatory filing done out here today. During the first year, holders will receive 50 cents for every 1,000 invested in a new low-volatility stock ETF. We don't know what that is yet. Until it grows to 100 million, when the cash benefit will be capped and shares and shared with all investors. The rebate is until at least April of 2020, and then a $2.90 management fee could kick in. Asset managers are getting increasingly aggressive on price as they seek to stand out in the ETF marketplace. Right now there's more than 2,000 ETFs. They're going to spend $50,000 to encourage investors to move into that fund. So watch how this works, folks. Okay. When day trading first started, you know, I'm going to bring you back a little history of basically Instanet. Electronic trading in general. The way that the biggest players, which would be, at that particular point, it was Instanet, it was Island, it was Tal ended up taking them all down. Tal ended up buying all of them, including the New York Stock Exchange. And the way it worked is this, is that at the beginning of the process, picture, you get an exchange up at the beginning of the process, and you need a bid and you need an offer, right? So what the exchanges offered was that if you were on the bid or on the offer, they would actually pay you a dollar to a dollar and a half if you got taken out at that, because that's how the markets were being made, because the markets were not being made by broker-dealers, because they didn't want the broker-dealers. The broker-dealers could be in there. They could be in there, but everyone else could be in there simultaneously. So what that did, and it did it immediately too, by the way, it gave them order flow in a huge way, and that's how all those businesses really started to take off, because what would end up happening is that if you had done enough trades and you just didn't lose any money, you could actually make money in between that spread. Okay, now fast forward a little bit more. As the companies start taking over each other, this is where the whole electronic trading came in an incredible way, because what happened then is that you had computers taken over, and you'd still get the kickback on the computers, okay? Then as that stopped, okay, as they got big enough and that stopped, then what ended up happening is that the broker-dealer community would start paying for order flow. So what had happened is that the large names that we know right now that are in the financial business, okay, the Oakmonts, the large funds, okay, then they could direct those orders into whoever they want to, and what was happening there is that you're paying for order flow, okay? So what they're doing is a smart idea. I suspect what's going to happen, I don't know if this one's going to be popular, but I suspect what we're going to see out here is you're going to basically see this come right down the pike, and we are going to go into a negative deal, because guess what? Even when Morgan Stanley was doing this, folks, I mean J.P. Morgan, when they were doing it, as you're making it free, we know there's nothing free. That's not how it works, okay? Particularly in the financial business, okay? All it is smoke and mirrors. So inside of that, what they are hoping for is that they're going to get all the order flow, because they have no, and that's how they make money on the deal. You can make money on the spread, you can make money on the order flow. So going to be intriguing to see how this works out. Let's go take a look at Royal Gold. Royal Gold today up $1.42. You're going after the swing high of $91.06. This is good. This is real good. Interesting. So we're pushing this high with 600,000 versus 370. This is going to be a good indication we're going to take this out. And if that's what we do, let's see. You got a nice ABC up on a weekly. We need 2 million. Which we can get easy. Okay, so check this out. This could be a weekly ABC up. Your A point on this is $80.72. Your B point is 91. It's 11 bucks. Your C is 86. So you're talking about 97. And 98 is your high. This is pretty cool, man. So the reason I'm saying this is more like an ABC up is that we only need 2 million shares at $91.06. You hit 91 today. We're already at 1 million shares. So it only needs, yes, 3 more days to do another 1 million shares. I suspect it's going to get it. Franco Nevada, FNV. Let's go take a look. So Royal Gold is a royalty company, of course. FNV, another royalty company out here. Franco Nevada, oh, look at this, nice. So Franco Nevada coming to its highs today. 664,000, they needed 841. So Franco Nevada needs more volume, but it looks like it's going to scale this whole $78 level. We're at 78.07, so it closed right at its highs. That's on the daily. We put this on the weekly. Okay, so the weekly we're going to need 3.4 million, and you're at 1.2. So that's 2.4. We need 3.4. I don't think it's going to do 3.4. Okay, well, it's going to need a lot more volume in 3 days, that's for sure, because thus far you've only done 1.2 and you're coming into 3.4. But guess what? It looks like it's going to break topside. It's pushing into those highs, and it does have volume behind that move. Aneco Eagle AEM, this has been a strong stock. There we go. This overtook the highs today, 44.31, and we did it with volume. Oh, this is cool. Okay, hold it. We got another ABC up here. This, folks, if you want to get in a good market, go check out the gold report, folks. This market, this gold market, this metals market right now, you get action in it. This is, we're moving. We're moving up with ABC structures, and it's coming from one stock to the next stock to the next stock. When you have that happen, that is a rotation inside this gold market that's tiny, by the way. And these large funds are just coming in, and once you get ABC structures on the way up or on the way down, that's when you know you really get a real market happening. In this particular case, Aneco Eagle's blowing this out. So you got, 44, 38, $6. $50 is on the way. Let's see what's up at $50. 47 is your swing point from July. Yeah, you're going 51. 51's the high from September of 2017. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
The TAS Profile Scanner is the most revolutionary piece of trading software that you will ever try. Wouldn't you like to approach the markets with confidence? As you begin your trading day, it's likely that you'll be faced with lots of decisions. In order to make the best decision, the first thing you'll need is a strategy that will help you minimize your risks. Whether we're in a bull or bear market, a good strategy is to have the tools needed to help you scan and analyze the markets before you trade. The TAS Profile Scanner instantly scans and filters over 2,500 global financial markets, such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, president of TAS Market Profile, the TAS Profile Scanner understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications, automated trading algorithms, and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. Whether you're looking at the trade matrix, the ETF heat grid, the market breadth, the landscape charts, or the many other features of the TAS Profile Scanner, this is a piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the markets and set up your trades. The team at TAS has even put together a 12-part video series to walk you through every aspect of the TAS Profile Scanner, which you can find directly on the TAS order page at TFNN.com. Sign up now for only $97 a month with a risk-free 30-day trial so you have nothing to lose and everything to gain. See for yourself how you can harness the full power of the TAS Profile Scanner by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services section. Remember, with a 30-day money-back guarantee, you have nothing to lose. Don't let another day pass you by without trying out this amazing piece of software that will revolutionize how you look at the market and how you place trades. Sign up today. TFNN has put together the best lineup of live content for traders by traders every market day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected minds in the business. TFNN broadcasts 5 days a week live from 9 a.m. until 5 p.m. Eastern Time. We have live programming every market day during market hours. Every morning, Larry Pesavento kicks off the trading day live at 9 a.m. and breaks down the opening bell with Trade What You See. At 10 a.m., Tom and Tommy O'Brien host the TFNN Bull Bear Trading Hour, followed at 11 a.m. by the team at TD Ameritrade and Thinkorswim with Fast Market. Basil Chapman hosts the Tiger Technicians Hour at noon, Steve Rhodes at 1 p.m. with the Trader's Edge, Dave White at 2 p.m. with the Power Trading Hour, and Tom O'Brien anchors the daily lineup from 3 till 5 as host of the Tom O'Brien Show. Tune in to TFNN's Tiger TV on your computer or mobile device, and you can always find us streaming on YouTube. TFNN.com, educating investors.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow finished down 96, NASDAQ up 32, S&P's up 9.5. And so what you have over in the UK is this, folks, okay? that the vote got defeated. Theresa May only got three votes more than she got last time, 391 to 242. They were rejecting the new divorce agreement, which the Attorney General said wasn't too much new in the first place. What we're going to have tomorrow is this, is that the Attorney General is saying that he said in an interview right after this was over that the departure date of March 29th, we have to extend that. That an extension is inevitable. Now, that being said, the bottom line is that they're going to be voting this week. Parliament is probably going to vote to postpone Brexit this week, and lawmakers, including some of May's cabinet, will likely try to maneuver to force the government to rip up its Brexit plans and start again. Members of Parliament are expected to vote Wednesday to take a chaotic no-deal option off the table. May said she'll offer a free vote, meaning that the government will not whip conservative lawmakers to take a particular side. But there's risk. All they managed to do is postpone the drama for another few months. It's notable that she included a second referendum on Brexit among the Parliament choices that they can face in the next coming months. Voting against leaving without a deal for an extension does not solve the problems we face, May said. I continue to believe that by far the best outcome is the UK leaves the European Union in an orderly fashion with a deal, and that the deal we have negotiated is the best and indeed the only deal available. A spokesman for the European Union, President Donald Tusk, said the result increases the risk of the UK crashing out of the bloc without a deal. He said that the European Union will consider any request from the government to delay Brexit Day, but there needs to be a credible justification for a possible extension and its duration. The European Union has done all that is possible to reach an agreement, and a solution to the deadlock cannot be found in London. May's job, which has clung to from one crisis to another, is now in greater peril than ever. May herself has said that if the deal was rejected, Parliament could force the UK to maintain closer ties with the bloc and a betrayal of the referendum result of 2016. She also warned of the risk that the divorce would be stopped altogether and that her latest comments will likely boast campaigners who want the UK membership in the United and the European Union to put another public vote. And they're in chaos over there. There's no two ways about that. Chaos is ruling. And, you know, overnight we'll see what is happening inside the pound. What happened out here today, the euro actually got some juice. Now, the euro hasn't got any juice whatsoever. The euro actually broke down last week when the dollar index went higher. Euro got juice, though. Bottom line is that it's inside its higher range. And this it's not over until it's over. That's what it really comes down to. Let's go take a look at a few of the silver stocks out here. You get First Majestic. First Majestic is up 24 cents. Now, this is coming up to its highs of 703. Pan American Silver, and this is still repairing damage that was done when they basically took over another company. This is gonna need a lot more juice. This is not a great looking stock, Pan American Silver. And this was like a high flyer for years, but this is gonna have to show a lot more strength. It hasn't done it yet, doesn't mean it won't. Great Panther is in a confirmed ABC structure up. It has another one going to 123 to 125. This had another good day out here. Yesterday, we went from a price point of 87 cents. We're at 109 right now. What you're going to see on the weekly basis, you get monster volume. It's already an ABC structure up on the weekly. And we bring this back. I think 125 is game pretty. Yeah, 115, the top of that is 146, interesting. So what you have here is that you probably get an extension to 146. That's gonna be quite a move. Great Panther was trading back at 52 cents in December, you know. And I've mentioned this a few different times. It looks to me, folks, that this flight inside the gold and silvers is the same type of flight that we had in 2016, and that was quite a move. And it's going to have everything to do with interest rates. You know, that's what it really is coming down to. You can see that this interest rate market, you know, just won't stop. And it's been the most consistent out here. If we take a look at the 30-year, what you're going to see out here today, 30-year blew away a B point of an ABC structure up with volume. The B point out here had 277,000 contracts. We do 300,006 contracts. Your high is 147.31. Guess what? You're at 146, and this is a three point, I think. 143.5. 2.5 point. 2.5 point, which gets you into the 140, approximately 147. 147.5. And the high is 148. Let me put this on, and that's a one-to-one. I'm going to put this on a continuous contract. US 1, right? There we go. Okay, so what happens when a continuous contract is that we can get a much cleaner look at where we are. Oh, this is pretty cool. Yeah, because if we launch this, this could be a larger ABC up. Because we didn't back down at all. And if it is a larger ABC up, it'd be 136, be 12.8 to B. That's 56. Yeah, it's 156. And it would make sense. We'd be popping right back up to where we were in December of 2017. That'd make sense. And then, you know, it'd be really wild, folks. This would be crazy if this is the case. Because... And then if we went sideways, look at the thing went sideways from 2016 to 2017. Well, actually, look at the exact date then. November of 2016 to December of 2017. So full year. Went sideways a full year. You broke down. We made our low out here at 136. You go topside again. And if we get this, then we go sideways again. You're building a monster head and shoulders bottom. And this is going to be like the Japanese... of rates, meaning that, you know, Japan's been going through this for years, that they've never been able to get their rates higher. And it looks like this is where we're going to be going. So this is going to be wild watching this thing shake out, man. And if that's the case, guess what? Let's go look at Toll Brothers for a second. Yeah, Toll Brothers is up there. That's not losing any sleep. $36. That's building cars to try to get up into the 37 once again. Yeah, if we're staying down there, what you're gonna see is you're gonna see these builders start going topside once again, because every half a percentage point that we come down, folks, the amount of folks that can afford homes, the amount of folks that basically go in the market goes exponential, and we have done just that in the last 6 months. You know, 10-year right now is 2.598. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion.
While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step-by-step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. I just got the API numbers out. So in the API numbers, we had a decrease of 2.5 million barrels this week in crude. Gasoline, you had a drawdown of 5.85 million barrels. And distilled, we had a build of 195,000 barrels. Bottom line, it hasn't done anything to the price of oil just yet. Let's get over. So where do you see this? Let's see where I put this article. Under here? There it is. So where do you see this, folks? This is something else. So what we had out here today, and this news was getting blasted, of course, all over the press. And what it was about was the scandal that's coming out of college admissions. And I believe we're right in the middle of college. More than likely, it's March. So we're right in the middle of college admissions once again. And what it's about is that they had, from 2011 to 2019, bottom line is that they're figuring $25 million has been paid, folks, in order to basically get wealthy parents' children into schools. The differential in this is going to be pretty intense because if you're just on the net, what you can do is you're going to see this in a lot of different places. I just clicked one little button, and as I'm clicking one little button, this was brought in Massachusetts, in Boston. But what they have is that they have the amount of people that got charged, and they have what they're charged with. And it starts right off that they're getting them on racketeering, conspiracy, money laundering, conspiracy to defraud the United States, obstruction of justice. And as you start going down this list, you get mail fraud, you get conspiracy to commit money laundering. It's just about on every single one of them. Conspiracy to commit racketeering. Now, the thing that's going to be wild is this. This is why I want to bring this up. So picture this. You have, and as you're looking at this, on the right-hand side, you're going to see what districts they're in. District of California, District of Texas, District of Massachusetts, District of Southern New York, District of Nevada, and District of Massachusetts. So what you're going to have is this. You're going to have wealthy individuals. So picture, there's three ways. Well, there's probably more than three ways, but these are the three ways that seem kind of evident to get into big colleges, right? And this has been going on for quite some time. You can be really rich. You give a lot of money to the college on a continual basis. That's your alma mater, right? Your chances of getting in there are better. That's been on. That's legal, by the way, and it's been on there forever. People like it, don't like it. It's legal. Then, bottom line is that, you know, we have some smart kids. They've done the job. They get into school, right? Now, this is like the well, then, of course, you get student-athletes. That's a real deal. They should get in, bottom line. Now, this is what you have happening here is this. We've had plenty of scandals on SAT tests, on people taking tests and all of this, right? That's happened before. I don't remember the actual parents ever coming down getting criminally indicted because of that. But bottom line, I remember plenty of scandals going like that. This one here, you're going to see a lot of different aspects of it. The reason that I'm saying that is this. You know, like, so picture this. Picture that all of these folks that are out here, right? And there's a couple that are in the market, and you're going to see the stock went down 10% today. The couple hedge funds, well, one's a venture capital fund. But what's going to come out here is that these, more than likely, these are folks that I would say that probably haven't thought they've broken the law, but in fact, not only have broken the law, they've broken a lot of laws, okay? And it's like one of those deals that it's not so much like a, you know, like there's some laws that you think that you absolutely have to pay attention to, otherwise you don't. These people are caught up in some heavy, heavy charges. When I first brought this up, I wasn't expecting to see racketeering charges on mail fraud charges in a lot of these. But that's what you have. And I'm sure they're basically, you know, they're going to basically going to have to spend some quite a bit of money on lawyers, all the rest of it. But bottom line, ethically, law-wise, there's no doubt. And I suspect what we're going to hear out here, out of plenty of them, well, this is no big deal. Everyone does it, you know, and that's not the case. You know, what I had brought up years ago, I remember that the first big downdraft I saw in the real estate business outside of 74 is a drawback, but this was in 85, I think. And what it was is that all these banks would just give you money, like, and you just sign away. And so many people had done it because it looked like, you know, it was normal. Bottom line, that wasn't normal either. And now in that particular case, you know, every bank went, these are the savings and loan debacle. Every bank, there was nothing left in New Hampshire. There was not one bank, not one savings bank. I don't think people did any time with that either. But bottom line is that you can see when so many people do so many things simultaneously, they think that that's okay. Now, in this particular case, you're going to see that is certainly, there's going to be the aspect, well, if you think you have this much money, you can do whatever you want to do. I can pay this person off. I can get them in there. And you can see why people have flipped out. There's no two ways about that. 877-927-6648. But that being said, they're in some, those are some serious charges, serious federal charges, particularly the racketeering one. Boeing's got big problems. We know it's got big problems, but technically, you know, you can see that people were buying it yesterday. As soon as it hit the gap at 365, they bought it. Stock is all the way up to 402, closed at 400. This morning opens at 384. You're down to 375. You got monster volume. This thing wants lower price. And, you know, Boeing has a problem. What has also happened, folks, is the FAA has a problem also in a huge way. The whole world, it's showing out here what is happening bureaucracy-wise. The world, you know, we were leaders. Guess what? The world is saying, hey, folks, you're out of your mind if you are not stopping these planes. The FAA is not stopping the planes. Bottom line, the rest of the world is saying, all right, we're going to stop the planes. And there's a whole aspect that the FAA, no doubt, was always a leader in, and now they're balking. They're balking, and, you know, like I said this morning, this is almost like the Jaws movie when you're talking about the aspect of Martha's Vineyard closing the beach in the summer. You know, I mean, I can see the argument. I can picture all these people sitting down simultaneously saying, hey, hold it, man, we can't ground these. We only delivered 300. We have 5,000 planes we got to deliver. It's 30% of the operating profit of Boeing. And guess what? They're going to have to shut them down. It's going to happen because just today, for the amount of countries that not only shut them down, few countries, folks, they won't even let that plane fly over their airspace. The reason they don't want to fly over their airspace, in case it does crash, is and hurt some of their own folks. So I don't think we've had the end of this, and I suspect in the next couple days they'll come up with some kind of a statement grounding those babies. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. And folks, if you'd like to test drive the gold report the way you do it, just come over to our website at TFNN, and you're going to see right under newsletters the gold report. What you can do there, you can basically take it. There we go. You can test drive the gold report for 1 month, and 1 month is $85. 6 months is $395. That's a savings of $115. 1 year is $695, which is a savings of $325. They all come with a 30-day money-back guarantee. So check it out right in the front page of TFNN. market-wise out here, what you can expect out here tonight. So last night, what you had, Asia is still catching a bid, man. Asia, this Shanghai market is on fire. It looks to me like what we actually did last night is that you come up and tested the highs, you had some lighter volume, so it's not a buy yet. But on a decent pullback, that market's going to be a buy, folks. It's a nice setup. It went up 24% so far this year, came down 4% 2 days ago, popped right back topside yesterday. But I expect you're going to see the more action in that market. If we go over to the UK and we take a look at the UK, out here, what you have with the UK, bottom line, sideways move out here today, 71.50, that's where you're at. It's going to be the currency markets that you're going to continue to see some big action on. In the next couple of days, we're going to see a lot more voting in the House of Commons over in the UK as they try to figure out, do we get an extension? Do we get a no Brexit vote whatsoever? We're going to vote on Brexit again, all of the above. I suspect the first one that's going to come down the pike is that you're going to get an extension. But they're pushing it as much as they can push it. But I suspect there's not going to be another vote about trying to get something done. The reason being is that Theresa May only got 3 more votes than she did in January. So the stats are way away from her, you know, because the defeat, once again, was sound. The defeat was 391 votes to 242. So you're trying to make up 150 votes. That is a monster number, folks. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership of it, and fly with it, folks. Everything you need is right inside you. Have a blast with it. Look forward to speaking it right here, back here, tomorrow morning, 9 o'clock. Meow! Go get them, folks.